Ending the week on an up note. Vertical line video. Vertical line writers.com. Edition. U.S. Arabic. Argentina. Brazil. Canada. China. France. Germany. India. Italy. Japan. Latin America. Mexico. Russia. Spain. United Kingdom. Home. Business. Business home. Economy. Media. Small business. Legal. Deals. Earnings. Business video. The Freeland File. Aerospace defense. Summits. Markets. Markets home. U.S. markets. European markets. Asian markets. Global markup data. Indices. M stocks. Bonds. Currencies. Commodities. Futures. Funds. P hub. Dividends. World. World home. U.S. Brazil. China. Eurozone. Japan. Africa. Mexico. Russia. India. Insight. World video. Reuters investigates. Decoder. Global innovations. Politics. Politics home. Supreme Court. Politics video. Tech. Technology home. Media file. Science. Tech video. Tectonic. Opinion. Opinion home. John Lloyd. Felix Salmon. Jack Schaffer. David Rode. Nader Mousavizadeh. Nicholas Waxshot. Bethany McLean. Anatole Kalitsky. Zachary Carabell. Edward Hattas. Hugo Dixon. Ian Bremmer. Lawrence Summers. The Great Debate. Ryan Salam. Mark Leonard. Stephen Grill. Allison Frankel. Breaking Views. Equities. Credit. Private Equity. M. Macro Markets. Politics. Breaking Views Video. Money. Money Home. Tax Break. Lipper Awards. Global Investing. Muniland. Unstructured Finance. Linda Stern. Mark Miller. John Bosick. James Seft. Analyst Research. Alerts. Watchlist. Portfolios. Stock Screener. Fund Screener. Personal Finance Video. Money Clip. Investing 201. Life. Health. Sports. Arts. Faith. World. Entertainment. Adly Enough. Cancer in Context. Lifestyle Video. Pictures. Pictures Home. Reuters Photographers. Full Focus. Video. Reuters TV. Reuters News. Video. Video Gallery. Video Transcript. Stocks finally made some positive headway after a week of mainly losses, driven by the continued partial shutdown of the U.S. government. There was some investor confidence after newspaper reports said Republican House Speaker John Boehner told his party colleagues he would work to avoid a U.S. debt default by allowing a clean vote on the issue. But there are still a lot of worries about the economic impact of the uncertainty in D.C. Richmond Federal President Jeffrey Lacker. Soundbite. Jeffrey Lacker, President, Federal Reserve Bank of Richmond English saying, Federal Reserve policy actions cannot necessarily counteract the effects of fiscal policy uncertainty, declining productivity growth or structural changes in the Labor Department. And all of these now appear to be playing a role to some degree or another. For the day all the major U.S. indexes were higher. But for the week the Dow lost ground but the Nasdaq managed a gain. And in Europe, shares rose led by banks as investors welcomed a more stable outlook in Italy, and bet the European Central Bank would continue to support the region's financial sector. Twitter was the talk of Wall Street. Its official IPO filing showed revenue at the social networking company almost tripled in 2012. It's expected to go public in November, the ticker TWTR, the exchange though, still undecided. And the devil is in the details. Shares of Twitter Home Entertainment soared more than 1,000%. Yes, investors mixed it up with Twitter. The clear case for reading the fine print. Or even just the name of the company. Its ticker was TWTR, until the Q was added when it went bankrupt. The stock was mercifully halted by the middle of the day. On the Nasdaq, a delicious debut for Potbelly. Shares of the sandwich chain, which is backed by Starbucks CEO Howard Schultz, more than doubled from their IPO price of $14 a share.